Because I don't know what's going on right now. It's just this weird communication thing between black men and black women. Yeah. Like, I sent you the clips. Because when I saw the clips, I was like, yo, I want to talk to you about some of these things that Ayanla and Van Zandt, because she was talking about, like, we're in a situation now where it's like, from her perspective, being a woman of 70 years old, she looks at it as an aspect of, like, women have become, black women have become voluntarily, like, masculine.
Yeah, because I know for myself, just because of the way I was raised, the women I was raised around, I've never had it in me to want to take place of a man.
Hmm.
I find my power in being soft and being feminine, especially being in a relationship with a black man who needs that softness, because when you go out into the world and you have to hustle and you have to grind, you don't want to come home to the same thing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Wow, you want to be able to come and settle down and lay your burdens down at the altar. Almost. Mm-hmm. And that safe haven should be a black woman. I should not be an aggressor to you. Mm. I should not be in opposition to you in any way, shape, or form when I know what you're facing outside of there.
There's definitely a disconnect in how we communicate with each other. Mm-hmm. And kind of like what Ayanla was saying, there's like a lack of grace that we offer to each other in our communication. Like, you know, even when it comes to our expectations of each other,
right?
You know, just like, we need to be sure that we're we're actively communicating clearly,
right?
Like what we desire from each other.
That part,
you know,
yeah.
Like our expectations a lot of times are linked to, you know, like really, really vague descriptions and conversations that, yeah, like, you know, you're basing your expectations off what other people have going on.
Right. Mm-hmm. I agree. I mean, and the thing is, because I was thinking about, because watching the other sister, Ebony K. Williams, talk about the aspect of, you know, even with it seemingly women are having to be less soft and harder, it seems like that's a byproduct of necessity.
Yeah,
you know, right. being somebody who was raised by a single black woman, I saw how my mother acted different when there was a man in her life, where she could exhale and fall into somebody, but when there's nobody there, you know what I mean, she feels like, okay, I have to be the provider and a protector. Yeah.
Right.
It's not a natural space for me, but it's a space that I gotta,
it's like an instinctual thing, like I have to fill in the gap, you know what I mean?
Right.
To kind of be there. And I mean, that's like, you know, my father always told my sisters, look, like, you don't want to have to be out here depending on no man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That was mentality that was instilled in a lot of young women.
Yeah.
Right.
Up. And, like, that's still carrying over. Can we talk about it? Can we talk about it?